100% virgin bundles for under $100.
Yo, hold up, okay, hold up. You see a bad bitch coming through, yo, what's the hola? I'm in that new, me and new.
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Gold Obsession. And today I'm going to be showing you guys this luscious virgin hair, 100% virgin bundles for under $100. Yes, I said it. I have in the inches 22, 2018 with a 14-inch closure. I mean, a 14-inch frontal. Saying this ain't no closure, boo. This a whole frontal. You know what I'm saying? Look how good she look. Look how... Okay, but yes, this is a 14-inch frontal. As you can see, this hair is not stiff at all. It's not stiff. It's not dry. It's not none of that, sis. Like, and this hair is... Listen, the hair is $98. The shipping is free. Where can you get wrong with that? So, I'm actually going to be showing you guys, not like how I plucked the frontal. If you guys want a detailed video on like how I plucked the frontal, bleached the knots, put together the wig, I'll go ahead and make another like video.
So, my camera did cut off into my intro, but this is the hair. This is how it came packaged. Now, I was a little afraid because it came packaged like the synthetic hair that I actually do use, but I got it in the inches 22, 2018 with a 14-inch frontal. The frontal came pretty dense, but I did pluck the hell out of it, as you guys will see in the next clip. The bundles came pretty full. I did think the hair was a little thin at first, but it definitely wasn't. And as you guys can see at the beginning of the video, honey, this hair is so luscious. So here is the frontal. This is what she's looking like after I have plucked her. I forgot to get a clip of it up close, how it looked before I actually plucked it, but she looks good now, and that's all that matters. Actually, as you guys see right here, I did do a little over plucking of the frontal, and I'm actually making a whole nother separate video on how to actually fix that. So if you guys want to see, if you guys are interested in that video, and if you want to see how to fix your frontal or fix your wig after you have over plucked it, I'll go ahead and leave an iCard above and in the video link down in the description box, so you guys can actually catch up on that. So as you can see here, I'm actually just drawing a line showing where I want to cut my frontal. And guys, if you're gonna do this, please draw the line a little bit more ahead of where you actually want to cut, because I drew the line so fucking close that some of the white was still showing when I laid my wig down. But I mean, it's nothing that a makeup wipe can't fix, but still, just take the necessary precautions. So when it comes down to cutting my ear tabs, I know a lot of, when I first started making wigs and stuff, this was like a huge problem for me because I didn't know how to do it. So you're just gonna wanna lift your wig up, lift the side of your wig up, and wherever your ear is, basically take like your nail or a comb and part over the top of your ear diagonally or whatever is comfortable for you, and make sure that the lace is cut around your ear and just cut that part. You're probably going to want to cut from the back, but you can do it from either way. It really doesn't matter. And yeah, so to lay my wig down, I did actually glue my wig down before I cut the lace, just so I could see, because this was my first time laying the wig down, just so I could see where I actually wanted to cut it or how the wig was going to lay once it was glued down, so I would know how much, if I needed to leave a little more lace here or a little lace there. So yes, I am using the Got to Be Glue just to glue this wig down, and I did do two layers of this glue. I did one layer of this glue, and I sprayed the Got to Be Glue free spray on top. So I let the Got to Be Glue gel get a little tacky first, and then I went in with the Got to Be Glue free spray and sprayed it over it, left it on there for another like minute or so, and then I proceeded to lay my wig down into the glue. Now when you lay your wig down into the glue, you want to just like you would do any other wig glue, or if you ever used Got to Be Glue before, you're going to use the bottom of a rag tail comb, or you want to just like press the lace into the glue, but you don't want to press the hair, or you don't want to try to like force it. So yes, moving on to the other ear tab, you're going to just repeat the same steps that you did before. Take a rag tail comb and part over your ear until it's comfortable for you, or cut off enough lace to the point where it won't be scratching your ear. And I would say definitely do it in a diagonal motion or a diagonal cut, because that's going to look the most natural, and it's really just gonna help the wig to flow. If you kind of cut it in a straight line, you're not really gonna have any ear tabs or any sideburns. I mean, unless you're gonna leave your own sideburns out, then that wouldn't be an issue. But if you're bald as hell like me, then cut it in a diagonal, sis. So when it comes down to cutting the rest of the lace, you can just use scissors or a razor. I used a razors for this and for most of the entire process, but I did have to go in for reinforcements with these scissors, because sometimes the razor doesn't get close enough. But you're gonna see as the lace disappeared into my freaking skin, like, what? But yeah, you're just gonna cut as close to the hairline, or try to not necessarily cut as close to the wig hairline, but cut the lace according to your hairline, like as far as what needs to be covered and whatnot. That's the way that you get a most seamless blend without having to leave like your hair out or anything like that. Definitely cut your lace on your head. Don't cut it on the mannequin head, because the mannequin does not have a hairline. She bald, boo, so she's not really going to be able to tell. You're going to be cutting to the wig, and if you cut off too much lace, it's going to be really, really hard for you to go back in and customize it to make it look as natural as possible. So right here, you guys are actually seeing what I was talking about the white line. So I'm actually cutting on the white line, trying to get as close as I can. I cut most of the white line off, but I had to, if I would have cut all of it off, I would have had to sacrifice some of the lace that I actually needed for my wig to look natural. So I did not cut that part off, and I just left that on there. I really didn't mind, because I knew I was going to explain in the video. So just, you know, make sure that you are marking a little bit ahead of actually where you want to cut, so that way you don't have the same problem that I did.
So right here, you can see I've taken my hair down, and I'm just looking at the hairline, and look at how I cut the hairline, trying to see how it looks. And I'm not even gonna lie to you guys, it looks really, really, really good, but I know for a fact that it could have looked better. So like I said, I'm actually going to link my how to fix a overplucked frontal video in the description box below. So if you guys are interested in that and you guys have experienced this problem before, you can go ahead and check the description box after this video, and I'll definitely be able to help you guys out. So let's talk about the specs of the hair right quick. So the hair, like I said, I told you guys the inches already. This is Brazilian body wave hair, but the hairline looks really, really good. It was very easy to pluck, very easy to bleach. Like I said before, every frontal is different. So some frontals, it may take you an hour to bleach. Some frontals, it may take you 20 minutes. Normally, it takes me about 30 to 40 minutes to bleach my frontals, because I like to get them as transparent as I can. So yes, also, as you can see, as you guys will see coming up, I actually can like part the frontal anywhere. It is truly 13x4. Let's see anything else about the frontal. Now, the frontal is the thinnest part of this entire look, but I don't have a problem with that, because the front of your natural hair is thinner anyway, and I feel like it definitely helps it to be more natural looking. I do wish it was just a little thicker, but it's really not that big of a deal, to be honest. I'm not getting any tangling from the hair. The only shedding that I got was from the frontal, but I'm pretty sure that's from where I plucked. I didn't cut any of my tracks, and I'm not getting any shedding from the hair. I'll try to include a clip at the end of the video of actually all the hair that I plucked out. To lay some baby hairs down on this wig, I'm just using the Got to Be Glue free spray, which I won't be doing anymore, because it really didn't keep the baby hairs down like I wanted to, because I didn't directly spray it on. I sprayed it on a brush. So if I spray it on directly, I know it will hold it, because I've used it before. But yeah, so other than the fact that I overplucked the fuck out of this frontal, this hair is very, very nice. I really like it, honestly, guys. I'm not bullshitting you, and I definitely feel like if you are looking for some affordable
virgin hair, this is definitely the way to go. This isn't any AliExpress hair, and I feel like it is it's cheaper and it's a better alternative. A lot of times you get hair from AliExpress and it stinks and it's nasty. It's just it's dry, tangled, shedding, like everything. But I'm not getting any of those with this. Also, you guys, it was free shipping. The only problem that I had was that it took a freaking decade to get here. I ordered it on a Saturday and it came, well, they sent it out on a Saturday and it got to me that Thursday, I believe, or that Wednesday, one of them. No, I think it was that Thursday. So, but yeah, guys, that's pretty much all I have to say about this hair. I will definitely leave the link to where you can purchase this hair directly. So I forgot to film my outro because my lashes wouldn't stay on and I got kind of irritated. So I'm just going to include some clips and some pictures of what it actually that I took actually when I got done with this. But hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys have any questions about this hair, make sure you DM me on Instagram at GoToSessions or leave a comment down below. Make sure you smash that like button, that notification bell, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys later. Mwah. Bye, guys. Thanks for the beat.